your hero should have. What should they look like?
We can make a list. So when you guys think about superheroes and their costumes and things like that, what are some things you could include? Like, for example, I'll start with gloves. I see a lot of cool characters on gloves. So what do you think of visually?
What else do you often see heroes, superheroes wear? Like, yep, capes. Capes is good. How about things on their feet? Do superheroes wear things on their feet? What do you got? Masks. Masks is a good one. And they ponder about masks. Does anything else come to mind? Like maybe goggles on a mask? Or what else? What else? Like a helmet, maybe? Something like that? Yeah, maybe he wears glasses. Maybe his weakness is that he doesn't see very well. How about on his shoulders or on his body? What kind of costume might he wear? What sort of things might he have? Does he have body armor on? Shoulder pads? Elbow pads? Yep. Knee pads? Yeah. A symbol? Like for his chest, like a Superman type thing?
Yep,
absolutely. Okay, so we've got a lot of good suggestions about what kind of things he might have. What sort of things might he use? Does he have, like, does he have a power of some kind? Or does he use weapons? He uses weapons. What kind of weapons do you think he should use? A sword? That's a good one. A shield? Yep, a shield is a good idea. Like webbing, like Spider-Man? Yep, that's possible. What's up? Okay. I think the shield is a really good idea. Defensive weapons are often seen as being more heroic than offensive weapons. So we've got a pretty good selection of things that he's going to visually look like. And as we keep talking about this, everybody's getting older. As we're talking about this, and Josh is going to start actually sketching this guy together and incorporate a bunch of these ideas. So, what's the second thing as you're starting to work out what your character looks like visually? The second thing you want to think about is what kind of hero is your character? What kind of things does he do? What do you got? Like, what are his powers that make him special? He's got fire powers? Okay. What do you got, Wolverine?
I don't know when he starts to strike. He might have one. I don't know.
He can run through walls. That's a good idea. That's kind of a new idea. What do you got? Water? Like he can control water, or like he can breathe underwater, or what do you think? He can breathe water, like Aquaman? That's an interesting idea. So what do we like best? We have to settle on a few things. X-ray vision, that's an interesting idea. What do you think? What's that? He can jump super high. That's a good idea. He can walk on water, or he can run on water. That's a good idea. So it kind of feels like we're all starting to lean a little bit towards water-based powers, which is interesting because we've never done a water-based one with one of these before. What's that? What is it? He can mimic any power. That's a an interesting idea too.
Yeah, I know. Like, I sold all.
What do you think, Josh? Are any of these speaking to you?
I sold all the skis, got me.
Like the whole water theme? Okay. We'll do a whole water theme. Now, the reason it's important to decide on what his powers are and where it comes from, because this is going to inform how he ultimately looks. So what Josh is doing right now is he's using a green marker on a whiteboard to make it seem like he's doing what a professional comic book artist would do, using a blue pencil on comic book cardboard, and he's making a really rough sketch. So if you kind of look closely at what he's sketching, it looks like the figure of a man, and then next to him is going to be the figure of a woman, but really it's just a collection of pretty simple shapes and rough lines. So now that we know that we're going to do water-based power and a water-based costume, that allows us to start putting in some details on exactly what he's going to look like. So, what do you got? Really? That's a good idea. That's a good idea. That's like taking Aquaman's powers and cranking them up a notch. So what do we think, almost all superheroes have a symbol, right? Like Superman has his S, Captain America has his shield and the star on his chest, the Punisher has a skull. What do we think this hero's symbol should be? What do you got? A wave? Okay, we can make a little wave. Yeah, what do you think?
I'm sorry, I didn't understand. A shield?
Like, what if he carried a shield and the shield had a wave on it? Like, it's a shield made of water? Like, it's a shield made of hard water? See, now we're cooking, right? So now we're talking about, like, how does he control the molecules of the water to make them hard?
That sounds fun.
That does sound fun. So it's a cool idea. Okay, so we have a water-based hero that carries a shield as his weapon. There's a wave on it, and the shield is actually made of hardened water molecules. So the next thing this hero needs is he needs his code name. What do we got? Ideas for code names. Anybody? What do you got? Waterman, pretty straightforward. Old school comic style. Anybody got anything a little different?
Waver.
Actually, I kind of like that. Waver, anything else? What's that? Fiery guy? I like the word fiery just in general, but I'm not sure if it fits the theme. What do you think? You think you should have a name like Water Clown? I kind of like Water Clown too. What do you think about that?
It's pretty fun. Water Clown. Nobody will expect him to be too dangerous.
That's true. What do you think, buddy? Never mind. Okay. Captain Tsunami. I like that too. All right. Do we have any kind of consensus on what his code name should be? We've heard Waterman, we've heard Waver, which I'm kind of leaning towards Waver. We've heard Captain Tsunami, which I like. What was that? Captain Pool?
Coral.
Coral? Ooh, I kind of like that. What if we combined a few things? What if we combined and we made him like the Coral Waver?
You could even have coral armor. One of the things we talked about was body armor. What if it was made of coral?
That's a cool idea. What do we think about that? Captain Coral, and Coral makes up his armor. And he can control water molecules and make them do things or turn hard. That's a cool idea. Right now, Josh is thinking, why did I suggest coral water? Coral armor. What's wrong with me? All right, so now that we kind of have a good idea, Josh is going to now start to use a different color marker to to sort of start to draw in the fine lines of our character and add details. And while he does that, we're going to dig a little bit deeper, because the next thing that our hero needs is what's going to actually make his story happen. And the thing that makes his story happen is we have to decide, who is he really? So what is his, what's his real name? What's his secret identity?
You're
good.
Tell me about what you're going to tell me about.
What do you think? What's his real name?
My wife's still around here somewhere, so.
I don't know. Is this a fictionalized
person?
It's
a real person. It's a real person. That's your money.
Rachel Hughes?
No, Mitchell.
Mitchell Hughes? Kind of like that. What do you think? What do you got?
So we got crime, you got an action adventure, you got sci-fi, horror, and then all those genres.
If you remember what it is, let me know. So we've got Mitchell Hughes?
Okay.
It's a real guy that you know? Okay. So we'll have to add a legal disclaimer to this comic. What do you got? We can just spell it differently.
He's always wanted to be in a comic.
Have you ever noticed that a lot of classic superhero names are alliterative? And by that I mean that they tend to start with the same letter, like Peter Parker and Bruce Banner. Connor? Connor's good. That gives us our alliteration. What do you got? What's that? Ben? I like the name Ben. Is there maybe any kind of last name you can think of that sounds like it goes good with Ben that maybe gives like a hint of like oceans or water or anything like that? Ben Reef?
That's the downside, but I can give you a copy.
Kind of like Ben Reef. What's up? Ben Pacific. What do you got?
I appreciate you coming back and listening to the air.
I'd love you to come back.
What's that? Paul Pacific? Could be. That's right. I have two little kids too, so I'm super useful. Anybody else have any suggestions for names? I like Mitchell Hughes. I like using Connor and I like using Ben. Is there a way we can put these things together? Yeah, what about Ben Connors? It's easy. It sounds like it goes good together. It's almost nondescript, right? Which is what a lot of secret identities tend to be. They tend to be pretty nondescript. So let's say his name is Ben Connors. That's his real name. So what does Ben Connors do for a living? What's his real job?
Okay, so about the Bullock family.
He builds cars.
Detective,
fisherman is good.
Monster hunter, archaeologist. They don't normally get along, but they go up there.
He builds water cars? So maybe the story takes place in the future?
Try telling the story when they do.
I like that. I like what we got.
Want to take a look at that, Ron?
What's that?
We're a nonprofit.
He builds fire cars? And he's a water guy? That would help with the safety of the factory.
$5. That normally gets you like a 20-page.
Working in a water treatment plant? That is a really good deal. What do you got?
Sign it for you. Unless you don't want me to.
He's a doctor. Doctor is good. He's an architect. Okay. What if he is an architect who is something you always want to think about? You're trying to think about the story, right? Like, so how are we going to tell a story? So maybe he's an architect who... Maybe he's an architect who helps design aquariums. Maybe he builds giant aquariums. He's a marine biologist. What do you think? Those are projects that you can win. What do you got? What's that? He's a diver. A diver is a good idea. Another thing about him being a diver, because the next thing we have to decide is how did he end up getting his powers? Now, a lot of times in comic book history, what the character did for a living is often related to how he got his powers. Right? Fantastic Four, Reed Richards was a scientist working on getting into space. That's how they got bombarded by gamma rays and given superpowers. What do you got? He's a super diver? A scuba diver? Okay. What if he is a... What if he's a scuba diver instructor? Scuba diving instructor? Is that kid puts him a reason to live, to be in the water? Now, let's give me some suggestions of how he got his powers. What do you got?
It's $5, which normally gets about 20 pages in comics. This is 35 pages at the same price, Warren.
He cut a shark, and some blood from the shark got into his air system and got into his body. That's an interesting idea. What do you feel about it? Okay, so there's like some pollution. Like, yeah, there's a chemical company. That's a great idea for a first issue. I love it. So he's a scuba diving instructor, and he's out in the ocean, and maybe he's on a solo scuba dive trying to have a good time. So something to think about is, in many, many cases in comics, a hero got his superpowers is often directly related to the source of evil that it's going to fight. This leads us to the last thing that you need to have a superhero is to have a superpower. So let's try to tie all of those things together in a way that makes sense. So we've got Ben Connors, who is a scuba diving instructor. He becomes Captain Coral because he got exposed to some kind of pollution in the water. In our very first issue, which I really like, one of a nearby like blue whale gets mutated and turns into a monster, and this is how his powers show themselves, because he has to fight it off. But what is the villain like? Who did this? Who polluted this part of the ocean? Who's the supervillain that Ben Connors is going to fight? I think that's an interesting idea. I think in a lot of classic type fiction, often elements are against each other, water and ice, or water and fire. What do you think?
Get a girl sign in here too.
There you go. The villain is going to be a girl. So what is she? What kind of villain is she? What's her powers? How did she get them? Same process. What do you got? She can breathe out fire. Okay. I kind of like that. That ties into what he's saying. Plus, it's the opposite of water. That makes sense. I like thematically that these things are working together. So how does this? That's a good idea. I like that. She's in a flame retardant suit, and she's somewhere where there's some burning toxin, and it leaks into the suit. She ends up getting fire powers. That's great. But what does that mean? What does that make her? What does she do for? What does she do for a living? What is she? How does she do this? Is she a scientist, maybe? What do you got?
She could stop rescuing people with fire.
They talked about wild.
So you mean that she started off trying to be a hero? See, now this is something that's really interesting. This is really interesting to
develop.
So she was trying to be a hero, and something bad happened to her. Because something bad happened to her, she turned into a villain.
It's $5.
So maybe there was she was a firefighter now, and she ended up getting fire powers through the process of fire. Her hair looks like flames, like she's a redhead like me, or like it's really like flames. What do you think?
I think that's a really cool visual element for her look.
You're an artist? Well, awesome, perfect. You're gonna love the end of this thing. What does everybody think about that? She's a firefighter, and she's trying to save people. She starts off as a hero. This is a really nice dramatic mix. What do you think? She has fire all over, like she's on fire all the time. So do you think that would make her like she's angry all the time? So that's another really, really cool idea. If somebody is angry all the time, what do you think that they look like? If you think about somebody who's angry all the time, what do they do? What do they look like? And how do they feel about stuff?
What do you got?
Just like the Human Torch? Now, is she like the Human Torch? Can she turn it off and on? Or is she always like this? She can turn it off and on? Okay. So, what's her name? What do you got? Okay. Okay. So, are you trying to say that she doesn't really turn into a human being that's on fire? She actually turns into it. Fire. She can't. Because that's part of her powers, is that she can like, make herself look like any kind of thing. That's a good idea. That's cool. How about her name? What is her name? Okay, what do you got? Okay, so she, now that's a really cool idea. That's actually something, that's something worth thinking about. What if her, what if it's not necessarily fire all the time, what if she was a firefighter and someone set a fire and it killed someone that she loved while she was trying to save them, and her emotions got the best of her during this moment, and she picked up flame powers through it, but now she's like a human mood ring. And so if she's actually happy, she ends up with water powers, and if she's sad, she has a different thing. And so that's a really cool idea. Let's go with that for a minute. So what sort of emotions go with what kind of powers? What do you think? So do you mean that, like, depending on what her mood is at any given time, she changes between trying to help people and trying to hurt people? So that's another interesting idea, because this means that maybe they're not necessarily enemies. Maybe him being a hero is trying to help keep her under control and stop her from hurting people when her mood changes and causes her to, like, flame up. And that gives us some really cool ideas for backstory, right? Like, what are the relationships between these two? Like, not only, what is the relationship between Captain Coral and this as-yet unnamed character? What's the kind of relationship going to be between Ben Connors and her?
Do they know each other and they're their secret identity?
Are they boyfriend and girlfriend, maybe? What if they're boyfriend and girlfriend?
What if they're brother and sister?
Brother and sister. That's interesting. Let's go with brother and sister. Let's say they're brothers and sisters. What's her real name? Something Connors. Camille? I like Camille. perfect. Do you get superpowers depending on your mood?
Do you look like that when you're angry? Does your hair turn off?
Do you go from being a superhero to a supervillain depending on your mood? What does your dad say? Yeah? All right, so Camille Connors. What do you got? Lisa? But what if Camille is her middle name? What if her name is Lisa Camille Connors? What do we think about that? And what's her code name? What does the general public call her when she's either on fire or controlling water or destroying the city depending on her? What do you think? Starfire? Okay. I like Starfire. One thing in creating comics you always have to be careful of is the litigious nature of Disney and Time Warner. Flame Girl? Okay.
Yeah, you look so sad. I'm not here making you sad.
Anybody?
Thanks, guys.
Like, can we think of any names that might like, tell us that her powers change? Things are different for her all the time based on how she feels. The Emotioner?
Ocean
Emotioner. I'm kind of digging the Emotioner. I actually think that's pretty cool.
Ocean Emotioner.
What?
The Ocean Emotioner.
The Ocean Emotioner?
I don't know.
Well, now we're getting stuff from the peanut gallery back there. What do we think? How do we feel about the Emotioner, guys? You like it? Yeah, I like it too. All right, so really quickly, just gonna recap our story. Captain Coral and the Emotioner are actually brother and sister in real life. And Captain Coral is a hero whose main job it is to keep the Emotioner from destroying the city they live in or the town they live in based on her emotion because of a traumatic incident from her past. What other little details? Like in the first issue, in our imaginary first issue, what other little details crop up? What sort of things happen? We already know that Ben Connors is a scuba diving instructor and he's out on a swim and there's some pollution and he gets into it, he gets attacked by a mutated monster, and his powers appear. Before they have any powers to show that they have a real relationship. So this is an interesting question with this story. Does Ben Connors know that Lisa Camille Connors is the Emotioner, or do they not even know that they're each other? They don't know? What do you think?
He should find out later in the comics.
Yeah, that's what you want. He finds out later that's actually his sister. Maybe one time she calms down enough and he figures it out. And maybe his sister in real life is someone that she constantly has to go visit because she used to be a firefighter and this terrible thing happened to her. It's just never been the same. And then he finds out that the Emotioner is actually her. What do you guys think? While they're fighting, he finds out? Yeah, and so then their fight takes on a super heavy emotional weight so it can't be the same thing anymore. What do you got? They're fighting side by side, like maybe there's an even bigger monster, and as they're fighting, he discovers it's his sister, and then instead of being filled with hate and anger, she gets filled with love, and they have to turn and use their combined water powers to fight off some bigger monster. That is genius. What do you think? I think that's a great idea. I think that those are all really, really strong ideas. We can make an awesome comic. I think we have. What do you think? That's an interesting idea. So you're kind of saying, well, so you're saying that he knows that it's his sister, but his sister doesn't know that the guy who's trying to stop her is her brother. And what he does is he creates a monster to stop a monster. That's, we're getting pretty deep in literature right now. What do you think? Okay, so do you think that they would be on the same team? Okay. So they're on the same, like, they're a team like the Avengers, maybe? But she's sort of like a loose cannon and can't always be trusted? That's interesting. What do you think? You're starting to think with dramatic tension. That is a really cool idea. So he doesn't actually see her, he hears her voice, he recognizes that voice, and then he has this internal moment where he's like, I know who that is, that can't be, I know who that is. That is a really cool idea. What do you think, Josh? Do you think we've got two quality characters that we can move on with?
I am super impressed. I think these are really cool characters. They look cool, and I think they have a great backstory and a great relationship with one another, which makes them a really interesting storytelling. You guys could totally run with this and make a really cool comic book.
Yeah, I think so too. So, essentially, in the space of the last, like, how long has it been? Half an hour? In the space of the last half an hour, we've created two new comic book characters with a really interesting backstory and probably enough different ideas to run through four or five different issues, which is a really cool idea, and we'll probably do this, you know, end up giving you guys like a Monica credit and royalty.
Monica, I'm very honored. Wild Bullets, I wrote it.
Sorry about that. So, what we're going to do is we actually produce a Create Your Own comic. So, we're going to give one to everybody here.
All right.
It's going to take us a few hours. So, it's going to be a little tough if we have tons of markers and large pencils and different things.